Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of NBA 2k16 MyGM Mode. My name is BrendenPlayz. Well, today's the big one. This could potentially be the last episode if we cannot clinch our way into the playoffs. Currently, we are in the playoff picture, but the Pistons have two games left. We have one game left. If we can win our game, well, we have a chance. We have a chance of securing a spot, but if we lose, let's be honest, the chances of us holding on are pretty slim. So we need to win this game. We're coming up against the Pacers tonight. If we can't beat the Pacers, and it's a team we've actually struggled against all season. Obviously, Paul George is just an absolute beast. Sometimes we just can't really match up too well against him. So it hasn't been a matchup that we want. As for a game, last game of the season, this is probably the worst game we could possibly have come our way. We didn't really want to take on the Pacers this late in the season. We'll be hoping for someone else, but we've got them and we have to try and find a victory. So like I said, potentially this could be the final episode of the series. As Anthony, well, tried to get the start there that we were looking for, and he's missed it, but they've taken it out of bounds. So we'll get the ball back, thank goodness. Yes, potentially last episode of the season. Obviously, we don't make the playoffs, our season will be over and the season is officially done and the series is done. And that's something that, it'll be sad, but we've really worked hard this season to try and get the Knicks to a position where they could potentially make the playoffs. That was our goal for the entire series. We're so close to getting there. We just have to get this one more win. And just like the Pacers turned over the ball, we have turned it over as well with an offensive violation of 3 seconds in the paint. That is not what we wanted. So basically, against the Pacers here, I think we need a good start. If we can get a good first quarter in and get an early lead, that'll give us the confidence that I think we need. As Paul George just easily getting there with a dunk. And that is something we have to try and stop tonight. If George can get hot, we're in trouble. Attempted three-pointer. Trying to go for the quick release and try and snap back with another score to get us going. But unfortunately unable to do so. They've hit back themselves. But we've actually got ourselves a bit of a lead there. There's a big block there from both. I think it might have been Lopez and Bazingas teaming up there to get that one. But we've actually built a lead here. And now Bradley in. Carmello Anthony working well together, and things are going okay thus far early on here, and our defense is looking decent, but that's not really good at all. Ooh, we're very lucky to get away with that one. But yeah, it's been an interesting season. We've kind of covered it over the last few episodes, been giving a bit of recap of the season. Obviously, Carmello, we couldn't trade him out even if we wanted to, had the no-trade clause, but I think it's a good decision that we kept on him anyways. He's been the staple of our team. He's been really, really good for us, getting a lot of assists, a lot of rebounds, as well as his prolific scoring. So he's really just been everything for us. He generally takes the ball up a lot of the time, really the anchor of the team, trying to steer the ship around. And that's, oh, Anthony, get the hell out of my way! And there is an easy layup for two. Anthony driving his way through the hoop, and he's able to get it in, and he couldn't capitalize on the N1 opportunity, and that might come back to bite him there. The lead is still five, though. They might be have to close that down. They'll get the offensive rebound and their own chance for an N1. So that's a good comeback for the Pacers. They've coughed up the easy shot last possession for the Knicks. Now they've been able to bounce back and get it in themselves. But just to finish it up, obviously Anthony has had a great season for us. And, you know, I guess him as a star player, we've had to really rely on his scoring. We don't really have many prolific scorers. We don't really have too many guys we can throw the ball to. And Anthony has been the number one guy for us that we can nearly guarantee a good possession from. You know, he's the one guy we can throw the ball to and expect points, and that's really what we've needed, and that's what we've really lacked. It's certainly off our bench as well. That's probably been our key weakness throughout the season. You know, we go okay the opening period, and the bench comes on, and things just don't go well. Right there, a wide open three opportunity, and you had to take that. And unfortunately, Grant couldn't make the shot, and now that has given the Pacers a good chance to come back, and they will, getting 2 points. So that's an example of Ben struggling there. And now Galloway driving through, he'll get a foul. And a shot to go at the free throw line for 2 points. He'll get the first one. Not a bad free throw shooter. Galloway, what a season he kind of had, going in and out throughout the season. Starting, not starting. Very, very interesting season he had indeed, and I would say he probably didn't live up to the expectations that we may have had on him. We were probably expecting him to be our starting point guard more so than Grant, and then eventually Aflalo actually took over that spot. And I know a few of you guys have been saying, oh, why did you make Aflalo there? But simply, there was no one else. We had really no choice. Grant and Galloway were just really doing nothing. And remember, we even had Calderon at the beginning of the season. He was just taking up far too much of the cap for really no return. So, yeah, so it's been a real interesting season. I think that's probably been a big part of our game that we've lacked as a point guard. But I guess Carmello often, you know, handles the ball quite a lot and makes a lot of the offense's decisions. So generally, he can even kind of transform himself into a bit of a point guard as Galloway for the big three-pointer. Not the best shot, but he got it away and managed to get it down for three. And coming into the second half here, the Knicks had the lead. Anthony, he was wide open, took the three-point opportunity. He missed, though. He so far has got 7 points, one rebound, and four assists. 29 points is 27. And Hill, he was wide open there, and he took advantage of that space. Ben Gordon now, bit of a mid-season signing as well. And he hasn't had the best season, but we've talked about him the last few games that he's been handy at times. Serafin, well, jumps over the opposition and gets the jumper at mid-range for two. And Serafin, that mid-range jumper of his is pretty handy. Obviously lacks a bit of height. Coming up against a big center, he can struggle there to defend or get into the paint and overcome them, but he certainly can make up for that when he tries to shoot mid-range with that jump shot. And there's a really poor turnover there as well. That's been another thing of the next season. But Serafin comes back, gets the block, and makes sure that the Pacers don't cash in on that turnover. And that is lucky because the Pacers were about to extend their lead before halftime. Ellis blocked again. This time it was Sanders, but they get the ball back and they still make the shot. So the lead now grows. And you can see the Knicks 13 from 25. It's not too bad from them. Pacers have taken a lot more shots. Still find themselves in the lead, been able to get a lot of offensive rebounds. And the Knicks have struggled, I think, throughout the whole season as well. We've really struggled to get a lot of offensive rebounds ourselves. You know, our rebounding game has been pretty weak. And I guess Lopez and Porzingis have to take the burden of that. But, you know, we try to bring in Sanders to help us with the rebounding. And I think he's done pretty okay at that. And the block shot as well. So that was another one of our mid-season signings that we had to try and make happen, as Sanders, well, he took a shot and that was never going to go in. That was a pretty bad decision for that shot. Ellis, though, takes the shot, and Hill with the over-the-back foul. So 5 points down, heading in towards halftime. The Knicks can get at least 2 points here before the break. That'll give them a bit more confidence that I want to be down by more than five before the break. Bradley, only 2 points from him so far. Snell for three, and a great shot by Snell right in front of the hoop and knocks down the three-pointer. And the gap has closed up a little bit, down to two. Hill, uh-oh, wide open, and Chandler returns the favor, and three more points for the Pacers. Or was that a two? And oh, Bradley! From three, wow, deep three-point range. He's near the halfway line, and he takes the shot, and he's got it off all right. That is a tremendous shot. Gets it, and that took the lead back to one at halftime. Now we begin the second half. So Bradley didn't exactly have a great first half, but what a way to finish it. Oh, what about that? Slamming it down, Paul George. How can you stop him? Aflalo now, as the starting side back on. Bradley trying to drive through. He's got Porzingis in support. Porzingis with the miss. And Ellis fires back with the miss of his own. Repko got the rebound, and they still couldn't finish it off with George unable to get it done with Anthony close to him. Bradley now, looking for some support. Porzingis, and can't quite get it. It won't go in. He was hoping for the bounce in. Ellis, though, some crafty footwork from him, but still can't lead to points. Plenty of misses now from both teams as Bradley knocks down another three-pointer. And that is huge, starting to really make a big impact here. Serafin, he can't get the bounce. Now the Pacers with George. Uh-oh, trouble here. Flolo, nothing he can do. A bad matchup there, and Paul George isolated a Flolo and really took advantage of the situation. But he's been given the blocking foul as Bradley's going to try and take advantage. He can't. 52-48 right now. Galloway, uh-oh. There's too many easy points there. The defense in the paint has really been a letdown here tonight by the Knicks, and they must win this game. The pressure is on for sure. Gibson now gets the two. Yes, he will. Not a lot of points for Gibson this season. He chips in here and there, and his points are certainly handy. Chandler. Uh-oh, wide open three-pointer. Well, this lead is growing, and that was just good teamwork there, isolating the defense. And uh-oh, Bradley trying to find someone. He finds Gibson, who got a decent shot off, but couldn't take advantage. And you can see the rebounds there. 16-19 in the first half, 4-10. A 6-rebound advantage for the Pacers. Here's trouble! Well, he got there, did Gibson, but his defense not enough to block that one from going down. And now, well, the end of the third quarter, they could have a big lead here coming into the fourth and final quarter of the season, potentially, as Grant gets some space and room to move and gets a much-needed layup. They needed those points. He's only got four for the night. But that's a big bucket right there. Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Hill's got Bradley on him, and the defense has been really poor, and it's going to continue, but they're lucky. Late defense, stopping that one from going in, but there was a bit of room there to move. Here's Bradley. Can he get some heroics again? No. Unfortunately, wasting too much time trying to find some room. Couldn't take advantage. Couldn't get any room to get the shot off. And by the time he had a chance, he couldn't do it. And unfortunately, the Knicks are now down by 9 into the fourth. Can they come back? It's gonna be hard from here. Well, they trail by 13 towards the end of the fourth. Porzingis tries to get that one in. It's not working. Things are just getting bad to worse for the Knicks. The Pacers are doing whatever the hell they want. They are comfortably beating the Knicks now, and you'd have to say this could be the end of their season right here. 15 points down. Is it nearly impossible to come back here with some poor performances like this? Porzingis, only 3 points tonight from him. 1 from 7. If you want to say why they're going so badly, take a look at that. Anthony for a desperation 3. It's not going down. And they're going to need some 3-pointers and soon, because they're in real strife here. But Ellis just... Anthony just left him alone. And more points for the Pacers. So their season, it's not looking good now for the Knicks. Anthony's just desperately trying to get something, and it's not happening. Oh, there's something. Flolo gets the steal. Anthony. He's got Bradley. And wow. Bradley right there. All he had to do was lay it up. It was simple. It was easy. And he still couldn't get it done. And I think right there, that just shows what our season has been like. It has been a frustrating one. But one that, look, some potential there, you know, but it just didn't happen for us. As a Flolo gets a three-pointer, finally! They've been looking for one for a while, and they finally managed to get one of them knocked down as a Flolo managed to do it. He's got 7 points for the night. He hasn't had a great season either. Not as many points as we probably would have liked or needed from him. And there's a triple team there, and it forces the poor pass. Anthony, can he finish it? No. Yurepko able to get the foul. But Anthony, can he get two, three free throws? I don't think it's going to really matter. They're 12 behind still. They're going to need an absolute miracle to win this from here. I don't know if they're going to be able to. They're going to need a steal and a three. I mean, come on. And they're not going to do it like that. Well, the Knicks are struggling. Their season could be over. The playoffs dream that we've had all season long. Oh, get out of the way! Paul George knocked down by Anthony. And Anthony's able to get that one pretty easily. There was no one around to help out George, and it cuts the lead back to 12. Anthony's had a decent game, but we probably needed more from him in a big game like this. The playoff stream could be over. If the Pistons win, they will take our spot, and that will be the end of our season. But look, guys, we've had a fun ride. I'm kind of conceding defeat that we might be in some trouble here. We'll find out in a moment's time, but 36 seconds to go on the clock. A miss there. They're going for a three. I mean, what can we really do? Bradley shoots for a three. No good. And they're just trying desperately to get something here, trying to close this gap. Because points differential will be a factor. If they are on equal points, the points differential, whilst this game probably won't have too much of an impact on it, they go out to 20 points, it surely will. So they're going to have to try and shut that down a little bit more themselves, because that could be a play, a big impact on their season. Gordon gets a two-pointer. Well, there's something from Gordon. We haven't seen too much from him here tonight. Gets his chance and gets a two-pointer with defense all around him. That was a good shot. That was a bit of a lucky make, but it's going to be too little too late. The season could be over right there. At least the regular season is over. And the Knicks finish it off with a loss. Anthony, 22 points. And the rest chipping in here and there, but really no one else contributing in a big aspect. Unfortunately for us, well, we missed out. The Pistons, due to point differential, have overtaken us. They were 1.2 points better than us. That breaks your heart. But again, maybe the Bucks might have actually gone ahead actually as well. So we might not even... Well, two teams, I think, have leapfrogged us, actually. So there you go. The Bucks and the Pistons both went ahead of us. And it was actually the Bucks who managed to sneak into the playoffs. So we, unfortunately, have not made it. And that breaks your heart, ladies and gentlemen. But let's go simulate. Let's see who won the season. Not that it really matters, but we'll have a look anyways. Guys, thank you so much again for joining us for this series of NBA 2K16 GM Mode. The Thunder have won this year's season. Well, come on, guys. That's never going to happen. So you know it's a video game. The unrealistic things can come to life through this game. Hope you guys enjoyed the series. Next time we do NBA, it might be a career mode. If we are going to do another NBA series, which I think we will, we might do career mode instead this time. So it's been great. We actually did finish this series. Wow. I'm actually a little impressed with myself. We actually got there in the end. It took us a long time, but we got there, okay? Thanks, guys, for sticking along the ride. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you all next video.